in hard sometimes. And we would not be the extraordinary organization that Blythe is without you. I could not have traded my wishbone into my backbone without you, Amy. Amy, there are women who are moving. Women who are weak, with tongues of fire. Me too. You too. We too are men, women, children once living in the darkness of fear. We too gather to ignite light on the shadows of injustice and abuse of power. You, Amy, who imagines a clean planet, strands of light like sunrise, amber, ebony, honey, strawberry, cinnamon, waterfalls of color for us who need to drink from our inner power, health, and nourishing care. You, with Claire, assure Madison a future to dare to speak her truth. Amy, you are ever moving to make reality our world longing for peace and inclusivity, economic justice, respect for every human's dignity. Freedom to love unconditionally, all of us, all of us. You came to glide and for over two decades combed the tangled strands of glide growing too fast. You did too, you were kind of home. Cecil flying in many directions, me threading trapeze safety nets faster than my fingers could count. You moved in to hold us, still free to create and grow and invent. Providing lessons in discipline without judgment, helping build structures without crushing the authentic ground from which we grew. Yes, Amy. Yes, Amy. Women, men, children are moving. We are transforming. We are loving. We are moving. Thank you for helping Glide become a movement of love. We love you.
Hello. Hello. Upside down. Let's watch and see. Watch and see. Amy without limits. For goodness, the design and success.
My therapist will earn the other $100,000 that I need to pay them to understand why this is so embarrassing. Think about that. 25 years ago, I was just a Jewish kid living in San Francisco when a friend said, "Do you want to go to church with me?" I said, "No." Because I described to them that there was three things that I would never do. So here's where you never say never. I don't do organized religion. I don't go on cruises. And I will never wear a matching t-shirt with someone. I've only kept one of those nevers. T-shirts.
The first time I walked into Glide, I didn't know this, but I was spiritually empty. I sat in the balcony for 18 months every summer, and all I could do was listen to the Glide Ensemble and cry. And then on one Sunday, and it was for this event 23 years ago, Janet and Cecil were on stage talking about ticket sales and asking if anyone in the live community knew anything about business. The friend I was with said, look, you're at church, go to the meeting. So sheepishly, I went down to, people know the green room, right? The green room, in which I sat with a group of people and I asked one single question, well, are the tickets on Ticketmaster? And I was met with horror and disbelief because everyone in the audience that was there said, what is that? And so I said, well, maybe I could help you. Fast forward 23 years. And the thing that I want to share with you tonight is really the following. Gandhi said, the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. When I was sitting there in the balcony and slowly moving down section by section, I started to realize that this special place, that these amazing geniuses, I'm not a genius, these are the geniuses. Yeah. A place that was rooted in three things: radical inclusion, empowering the most marginalized that no one cares about, and practicing unconditional love. And when, let's put the Ticketmaster aside, when I realized the gem, the absolute brilliance of what these two people and 200 staff members who give their life and their soul and their dedication to something very simple, serving the most marginalized. The people that often you and I walk by on the street. We have become a world that is very much about me, not a world that is about we. And Glide, for the last 65 years, has represented a we world. A map, a way that if we choose, we can live our life. So what I want to share with you tonight is that there's so many things that this actually has given me. And I have found myself in the service of others. So I urge you, in whatever your politics are, because this isn't political, this is just about being human. Yeah. This is just about being a human being, not a human doing. So what I urge you tonight is whatever your service is, wherever you feel grounded, I urge you to get involved. Find yourself in the service of others. There are a number of things that have happened to me since I sat in that balcony. I met my amazing wife. Yeah. I witnessed the genius of two people that, believe me, when I went to Wharton Business School, I didn't learn any of this. And what I learned sitting next to these people, being their wing person, was that the creativity and the love, the unconditional love, heals everything. Tonight, I pass the torch. Where's Kay? She is a rock star. She is somebody who's going to take this organization to the next level. And side by side with folks like Rita Shimon, the amazing leadership team, Karen, Jay, Theon, Angela, you guys have not seen anything yet. With Cecil and Jan and a creative leadership team, I believe that Glide's best days are yet to come. So in summary, what I want to tell you is that the irony of all this is that in service, I found me. In service, I found the best of me. In service, I learned how to be an authentic leader, how to be somebody who could be vulnerable. I learned to be human. And I urge each of you to find that in yourselves. So just a simple thank you for the honor of standing side by side with you, Cecil and Jan. It's been the honor of my life. For an amazing board, we're the board members. If you're here, please stand up. Let's give them a round of applause. Beautifully introduced to my family that's here, sitting on the table right next to me. Thank you for your love and support always. To my friends, many of you are out here. To my YPO posse that's here. To my Madison Reed peeps. Remember, you always have to be settled. This is important. And we are changing the world, hair strand by hair strand, folks. And last but not least, to the OG Madison Reed. Madison, stand up. There she is. And to my amazing wife, Claire, who has never done anything but support me in everything that I've done. And when there were late nights and late board meetings and I'm not the best on time person in the world, she would always say to me, you're doing the work of the world and that's all that matters. So Clara, I love you and I thank you for that support. So, I've always wanted to do this my entire life. Air it out.
You are an inspiration. Because you have the strength that's unbelievable. It's just so inspiring. So much that I wrote this song for you. And I wrote it in first person, imagining that it's you talking. And it's called No, I'm not going to make you sing.
John, come
sing it. The choir, we've been working on this tune, and we're going to sing it for you.
Thank you. He doesn't understand.
Climb it up.
Thank you.